How is mHealth, mobile health, relevant to the work that you do?
Well, my work is looking at this emergence of essentially a nervous system for humanity. We've had, you know, billions and billions of phones out there all of a sudden. That means you can have digital communications with most of the adults on the planet. It also means most of the adults on the planet are carrying around little sensor packages for how they sound and where they go and how they're walking and things like that. And so the question is what do you do with that? Well, there's many things you can do. But if you know where the people are and how the people are behaving, one of the key things you can do is look at health variables. So you can look at the progression of flu or other sorts of infectious disease. You can see how individuals are doing relative to other individuals. If you look at diagnostics for quality of life, most of them involve things like socialization. So if you can look at the data on a phone, you can give a rough estimate of a person's quality of life. This is critical for any sort of triage or recovery operations in medicine.
So this topic came up as in the Council on Global Agenda, mm-hmm. which you're a part of. How did that come about, and what were your expectations then of this particular event versus the broader dialogue?
Well, I think the topic came up due to Paul's leadership and interest in it. It's really one of the two main topics in the Council. One is personal information, and the other is mHealth. And really, they're sort of the same. mHealth is personal information around health, and Paul is particularly interested in that. And the discussion is always torn between healthcare, which is the existing sort of medical hospital doctor system, and health, which is the personal system. And this conversation reflects that divide still, which is that there's a lot of people concerned about third-party payers and HIPAA and things like that. And then there's a lot of people saying, well, look, we can do things we never did before to empower individuals. So what's happening with the conversation is it's becoming more clear about the fact that there's two types of business model, two types of applications, and that both have enormous possibilities. My personal favorite is the personal health, because that can reach anywhere in the world. It can reach where there almost are no doctors. And that's a really, really transformative possibility.
In this particular event, did you any key takeaways or any aha moments that you're going to go and reflect back upon, or some of the changes in the way you're looking at this problem?
Well, I think that there were two or three things I heard that were very hopeful. One is that there's the UN Foundation is really thinking about building a CERN, a big test bed, for these mHealth things. That's a personal passion of mine. That's what we're doing at MIT, so that we can actually ask, do these things work in the real world? So there's a natural partnership there. The second one is a little more esoteric, but it's a way of completely transforming the way drug discovery and validation is done by redoing the underlying statistics. The way things are done now is based on statistics that were invented in 1900. But the statistics that are vetted in the year 2000 could make the process dramatically more efficient. And that's really what we need to do, because the world is becoming more fluid, it's becoming more changeable, and to keep up with it, we need essentially continuous testing, which is only possible with the more modern techniques.